So I wanted to make a video on how to make Twitch panels using Canva. I am new to Canva. I don't really use Canva. I use Photopea, I use Photoshop. I use more advanced tools, right? But I really thought, oh, since a lot of people are using it, maybe it's like a very powerful tool that everyone can use. Turns out that while I was practicing, basically trying to make this video and giving you advice on how to make amazing things using Canva, I realized that Canva is probably the worst tool that you can possibly use to do anything remotely creative when it comes to graphic design. I'm exaggerating, maybe a little bit. Yeah, I will show you how to make panels with Canva, but I'll also show you how easy it is using any other tool super fast. But we will begin right after this message from our sponsor. I am heated up and I'm ready to go. This portion of the video is sponsored by Owned. Owned is your one-stop shop for customizing your live stream. They have a wide variety of customizable products from your logo, your banner, your offline image, your animated overlays, your sub emotes, your loyalty points, subscriber badges, everything from start to finish. When checking out their complete packages, right here you will find the interactive showcase. So if you want to know what the donation alert within the pack would look like, just click on it. And there you go. Then you have all the options, animated overlay, webcam overlay, which look at that, they even considered people who use green screens. They also provide gaming mascots and an avatar maker, but I'll let you guys figure that out. All you have to do is go to own.gg/gallevel. That's own3d.gg/gallevel. So if you've never used Canva before, of course, go to Google, type Canva. It will bring you to Canva, or you can type canva.com and you show up here. You can connect with whatever account. Just click identify yourself. Boom. It will bring you here once you create an account or log in with your email or whatever. And then here on the search bar, there's a couple of templates. You can type Twitch. Since we're doing Twitch panels, you can type Twitch panel, for example. And this is where it started looking not too great for me. There's a lot of Twitch panels. Cool. The design, there's not a huge variety. It's mostly like cute. To be fair, the people that I know that use Canva tend to lean towards the cute side of things. But fun fact, this little icon means that you need to be using Canva Pro, so you need to pay for it. Or this little icon is a paid template. So for this thing, granted, there is an illustration and all of that, I'm not taking away from it, you would have to pay if you wanted to use that. Of course, it's already pre-made, not even a lot of them that are pre-made. But yeah, not a lot of choice. What's the pricing here? Oh, of course, don't even give me the price, just tell me to start my free trial. Not falling for it. Let's click on pricing. 110 euros per year. So a little less than 10 euros per month. Yeah, the same price as Netflix to get those designs that we saw. This is what I managed to create. Do I like it? Not really. Did it take me a long time to realize that that was the only things that I could do? Yes, I actually cannot save with transparent background for free. Oh no, you gotta pay. You want transparent background? You gotta pay anyways. So what you would do is let's go home. That's because that's what I want to do. I'm already home. I want to go home. You would go and create a design, top right. And then here it would be like, what kind of design? And you can click custom design. Twitch panels are resized to 320 pixels width. So what I like to do is double that in order to have a better looking thing. And let's go with 200 for the height. So it's like, you know, banner size. Boom, this is what we get. So remember that we cannot have transparent background, which I'm so mad about. Now, the style of design here is per layer, but not Photoshop style layer or Photopea type or Pixlr. It's Word 2001 type of layer. How do I know this? Because I use Microsoft Word in order to make graphic design when I was 10 years old. Anyways, let's pick a background color because we don't have a choice anyway. It's not going to be transparent for us. Let's go with a dark gray. All right, here. Okay, boom. And then quickly we're like, okay, what am I going to do? What am I going to do from now? Let me find some elements. And the elements are shapes, weird looking Pixart, and images. Oh, if you want tables, you have tables. Canva is not made for, you know, like gamer type graphics or whatever, but we can use it. Maybe we can use this. What is, I don't know what that represents. Oh, it's a percentage thing. Let's use that. Let's use that to our advantage. All right, let's put that in a corner. Let me go back here and let me drop another one. Drop another one, and this is gonna be our main colors. All right, let's just mix a bunch of shapes together, see what we can come up with. I'm gonna create this one. Okay, it already has the right color. I'm gonna drag it up, drag that down on the corners, just like this. And we're gonna do the, you know, the easy button of graphic design for gamers or whatever it is. Make it diagonal because diagonal means futuristic. 45 degree angle. Let's drop that here. I'm gonna right click on it. I'm gonna click copy. I'm gonna right click somewhere else and I'm gonna click duplicate. And I'm gonna drag this on the other corner, kind of keeping the same distance, but it really doesn't matter. It's not gonna look good either way. Let's let's go into line and shapes and let's click see all, because we're very, very limited. You cannot just skew something, right? If I wanted a skew rectangle like that, I need to find a skew rectangle, which is so messed up. All right, let me do this and let me kind of make it match ish when it comes to the angle. Nice. And now I can drag the corner, which is the only way to proportionally scale, by the way. Yes, I am mad about that too. How did you know? Let's say I wanted to add like a shadow to this. Maybe I don't know how to use Canva. To be fair, today is the only day that I actually gave it a try. There's no way that I can just add a shadow to a shape. What kind of editing stuff? Anyways, let's continue. Let's add this. Let's try to center it. And now we will add our text. Okay, text, you can either just add a normal text and then you customize it, or you can pay for a bunch of them, or you can add like those weird article sale, feeling cute. Oh no, never mind, this is pro version. Let's just add a heading and let's type about me. Now, if you're making panels, you want to go with your longest word on the first panel so you can establish the size. You want everything to be the same size. Usually Instagram is one of the biggest words that I use for my panels. Let me just retype that. Oh, I can press this and keep hold. I didn't know that actually. In order to move the text, I need to hover over the top bar and then move it. All right, that's not bad. Let's go to the color and we want that dark gray, as if this was transparent, but not really, because we're gonna go ahead and add a style or effects to it. You might think, oh, effects, oh, I can add just one little shadow or one little glow. No. They're all pre-made and you have to decide between one or the other. And that's it. That's it. How much is that? Nine pre-made basically effects. You can have the glitch, the neon, the one with the background, the echo, which is what we're gonna probably end up picking, that one, and the outline and the drop shadow. Can it blur? Oh, thank God it can blur. Cool. Nice. I don't know what lift means. Oh, it's just like a very, very blurry drop shadow. This is horrible. Anyways, I'm sorry. A lot of people who are super attached to software are gonna be like, oh no, why would you? I use it, so it must be good. You cannot criticize it because I use it. I know I don't have experience when it comes to graphic designer, but how? I will not let this professional graphic designer actually criticize my choices. I'm not criticizing your choices. If you're starting out, this is great. But hey, now you know that from a graphic design perspective, this is not a good software. It's not good at all. And if I sound frustrated, it's because I am. I am frustrated trying to make this look like it was linear burn because there's no blending modes on this. So how am I going to make something look good if there's no blending mode? I don't know. Anyways, the reason why you want to go like this with the biggest word, actually, we can make this a little way bigger, actually. Maybe we actually want the text to be lighter than that. Let's go with this, or just white. Let's go with white. White is very visible, right? Boom, boom. The only big advantage here is that you can download, you can add pages and download a lot of them all at once. So for example, if this is my about, I can go here on top right where it says duplicate page. I can duplicate the page. I can double click and then I can type artwork. Whoops. And then I can duplicate and I can type subscribe, and then I can type, oh, this one's going to be my rules, and this one's going to be my specs. And then top right where it says share, you can go to download. You can't pick the size because God forbid you want to resize something without paying. It's fine. Transparent background, you got to pay. Compress files, lower quality. What? You gotta pay. If you're doing this for a website, you gotta pay. All pages 5. Okay, cool. Save download settings. I don't care. Let's click download. Oh, there it is. It downloaded it in a zip file in a random folder. Okay, cool. So I had to relocate them, and then you have to right click and then extract to Instagram. If you have, you're using 7-zip or whatever, just unzip it. And then boom, you have all of your stuff just done in a couple minutes. Does it look good? Not really, but let me show you something real quick before we go, because congratulations, you know how to make panels now. Just go to Twitch, upload them. If you were to use photopea.com, for example, right, and I were to do the exact same thing, so what was it, 640 by 200, right? Cool. Let's put the dpi at 300 so we have high quality. Press enter to create, and in here I'm gonna go and pick my rectangle tool. And I'm going to do this. Actually, I can even control Z and do a rounded rectangle. Let's put 30 pixels, see how that looks. Nice, because we will have the option of having transparency. Now I can press control alt T and I can hold control to skew this rectangle a little bit. Don't worry about it getting off screen. We're gonna fix that a little bit later. Boom, nice. And now I can just hold that side, or you can hold shift in order to actually stretch it out a little bit. Boom, nice. Double click on the icon to change the color. Go here and get yourself a nice color right now. And if you have a picture of yourself, let's go ahead and add an ellipse. I held my mouse over the shape tool and I'm gonna do this just like that. Okay, that's nice. Let's make this a little lighter gray. Nice. Okay. Let's create another rectangle. Boom. That's not a rectangle. Control Z. Let's go rectangle this time. Actually pick it. Let's create this like that. And let's Control Alt T. And let's try to match the rotation here. We're going to bring it right there, kind of in the middle. And then let's see what type of rotation we're working with. Okay, that's nice. So now we can double click on this and pick that color that we had. Let's go more for a mint looking one. Okay, I can hold Alt on my keyboard, click in between those two shapes. Actually bring it down there. Sorry. Click in between the background and that shape to create a clipping mask. Boom. Now it only adheres to whatever is at the bottom. We can even move it inside of here, as you can see. Right, we're going to keep it around there, and I'm going to duplicate it by holding Alt and dragging up in the layer list, and I'm going to drag this over there so we have kind of a duplicate just like that, just like I said. Okay, click on the first one and let's click on effects. Let's say that we want it to glow, right? A shape, we want the shape to glow. You can just add an outer glow. Pick the color of the outer glow. Oh, it's automatically a color picker as soon as I have to pick a color. Boom, I can make the size a little bit bigger. I can lower the opacity on that so it shines just a little bit. I can even go on the effect now that is near my layer. I can hold Alt, drag, and drop it in there. Maybe I want this thing to also glow. Let me do the same thing then. Boom, there you go. But let's say that I want a stroke on this, or maybe a shadow or whatever it is. Just double click on glow. It's gonna bring you to the layer style. You can click drop shadow, which you can see over there. I'm gonna click on drop shadow, go back here so we can see what we're doing right there. You can even bevel, emboss. This is literally Photoshop, but free and also online. Easy things to do right there. Boom. Click OK. And we already have, so we're already working with something that looks 10 times better. Let me duplicate this sphere, the circle. And a Control Alt T to transform. I'm gonna hold Alt and drag it down just a little bit. Nice. Press Enter. You're gonna see where this is going. Press T to add text. Click once. Type about me. Select it all and click on that color up top. And you can pick the main color if you want, or you can pick white. Click OK. And here you can click on the little arrow near the size and then play around with the size right there. Usually, again, you want to type like Instagram or something that is big just to make sure that you have the size correct. Maybe we want this to be full caps. Select this and just like that. Click anywhere away from the text in order to move it. Look, I can move it from here. Isn't that nice? OK, now why do I have the circle here? Maybe I want to incorporate a picture of myself. Let me do this. Go to my Twitter, right click, copy image, and I'm gonna click on that second circle, Control V, and here I am. Control Alt T to transform, bring that down, by dragging the corners, and then I'm gonna do that little trick about clipping mask. Press Enter to confirm the transform, and I'm gonna hold Alt, click on it, and boom, now it only adheres to the sphere right underneath it. I can even move it around if I want to. Maybe I want myself to be facing the other way. Control Alt T, right click, and then flip horizontally. Now I'm facing the right direction. I'm actually looking at about me, or whatever that means. Anyways, now let's say that you wanna add more to make this look a little cooler, right? I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate that shape. Hold Alt, drag up, Control Alt T to transform. Hold Alt, drag down, and I messed up. Control Z, select the shape that is underneath. Okay, Control Alt T now. Hold Alt, drag down. Place this in the middle of the text. Press Enter, double click on the icon, make it darker or brighter. It's not that visible. Oh, because it's under everything. Oh my God. Bring it back up. Nice, just like that. And you can even add a shadow to that one too. Shape one, drop shadow, boom. Now it has a drop shadow, looking really cool. Let's go to a website that has copyright free images, like Pix here, boom. And let's find the first thing that looks cool. That one, nice. Right click, copy, go back to Photopea. On top of this, let's click Control V. Nice, let's lower the opacity. super nice. Let's hold that Alt in order to create the clipping mask on top of it. Boom. And now it only adheres to whatever is underneath it. Let's Control Alt T in order to change the size and move it around a little bit. And there you go. There you go. It's that simple. We might even want to add a bevel emboss on that layer all the way at the bottom. Click there and make it like look a little bit more 3D. Not too much though. You don't want to overdo it. I don't even know if that's visible. It is kind of visible. You can see shadows here and highlights up there. And this is how you create a dope about me. I would probably want to add an outer glow that is the same. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Is that even comparable? And here's the fun fact. Here's the funnest of the factest. You can turn off the background and boom, you have a transparent background and you can go File, Export As, PNG, Save. That's it. Your file is here. You can upload it to Twitch. You're ready. Fully transparent, will look good on light mode, whoever uses light mode, and also for people who use dark mode. Oh yeah, but what about the rest of the text? Double click on the T. Rules, well, type it correctly. If you want to keep it in the middle, make sure that you click here, paragraph, to center everything, and then place it kind of in the middle. So now if I type rules, boom, in the middle, save that, and now I can go ahead, type specs, in the middle. Schedule in the middle. Remember, start with your biggest text so that you know which size it's gonna be. Of course, this is a little too big, but it doesn't matter. I taught you how this thing works. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think about it. Don't use Canva to make your graphics unless you really want to, you know, quickly spit out something real quick. Please don't pay for it. I don't think it's worth it. Just learn basic graphic design, like, oh, I created a rectangle. I tilted that rectangle. That's it. That's it. That's it. Color theory, pick one or two colors, run with it, pick a graphic style, run with it, and you're Gucci. If you would like to see more tutorials like this, let me know in the comment section below. But for now, I will ask you to go on Twitch and follow your boy. Watch your boy. And I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level.